Gauri, ninth Mahal. Holy sadhus, rest and peace are in the sanctuary of God. This is the blessing of studying the Vedas and the Puranas, that you may meditate on the name of the Lord. Pause. Greed, emotional attachment to Maya, possessiveness, the service of evil, pain and pleasure. Those who are not touched by these are the very embodiment of the Divine Lord. Heaven and hell, ambrosial nectar and poison, gold and copper, these are all alike to them. Praise and slander are all the same to them, as are greed and attachment. They are not bound by pleasure and pain. Know that they are truly wise. O Nanak, recognize those mortal beings as liberated who live this way of life. Gauri, ninth Mahal. O mind, why have you gone crazy? Don't you know that your life is decreasing day and night? Your life is made worthless with greed. Pause. That body which you believe to be your own, and your beautiful home and spouse, none of these is yours to keep. See this, reflect upon it, and understand it. You have wasted the precious jewel of this human life. You do not know the way of the Lord of the universe. You have not been absorbed in the Lord's feet, even for an instant. Your life has passed away in vain. Says Nanak, that man is happy who sings the glorious praises of the Lord's name. All the rest of the world is enticed by Maya. They do not obtain the state of fearless dignity. Gauri, ninth Mahal. You people are unconscious. You should be afraid of sin. Seek the sanctuary of the Lord, merciful to the meek, destroyer of all fear. Pause. The Vedas and the Puranas sing his praises and enshrine his name within your heart. Pure and sublime is the name of the Lord in this world. Remembering it in meditation, all sinful mistakes shall be washed away. You shall not obtain the human body again. Make the effort. Try to achieve liberation. Says Nanak, sing of the Lord of compassion and cross over the terrifying world ocean. Tada Gauri Ashtapadis, first Mahal, Gauri Guareri. One universal creator God, truth is thy name, creative being personified by Guru's grace. The nine treasures and the miraculous spiritual powers come by contemplating the immaculate Nam, the name of the Lord. The perfect Lord is all-pervading everywhere. He destroys the poison of Maya. I am rid of the three-phased Maya, dwelling in the pure Lord. The Guru's teachings are useful to my soul. Chanting the Lord's name in this way, my mind is satisfied. I have obtained the ointment of spiritual wisdom, recognizing the word of the Guru's Shabad. Pause. Blessed with the one Lord, I enjoy intuitive peace. Through the immaculate Bani of the word, my doubts have been dispelled. Instead of the pale color of Maya, I am filled with the deep crimson color of the love of God. By the Lord's glance of grace, the poison has been eliminated. When I turn away and become dead while yet alive, I was awakened. Chanting the word of the Shabad, my mind is attached to the Lord. I have gathered in the Lord's sublime essence and cast out the poison. Abiding in his love, the fear of death has run away. My taste for pleasure ended along with conflict and egotism. My consciousness is attuned to the Lord by the order of the infinite. My pursuit for worldly pride and honor is over. When He blessed me with His glance of grace, peace was established in my soul. Without You, I see no friend at all. Whom should I serve? Unto whom should I dedicate my consciousness? Whom should I ask for? At whose feet should I fall? By whose teachings will I remain absorbed in His love? I serve the Guru, and I fall at the Guru's feet. I worship Him, and I am absorbed in the Lord's name. The Lord's love is my instruction, my sermon, and my food. Enjoined to the Lord's command, I have entered the home of my inner self. With the extinction of pride, my soul has found peace and meditation. The divine light has dawned, and I am absorbed in the light. Preordained destiny cannot be erased. The Shabad is my banner and insignia. I know the creator of His creation. I am not a learned pundit. I am not clever or wise. I do not wander. I am not deluded by doubt. I do not speak empty speech. I have recognized the hukam of His command. Nanak is absorbed in intuitive peace through the Guru's teachings. Gauri Gwareri, First Mahal. The mind is an elephant in the forest of the body. The Guru is the controlling stick. When the insignia of the true Shabad is applied, one obtains honor in the court of God the King. One cannot be known through clever tricks. Without subduing the mind, how can the value be estimated? Pause. In the house of the self is the ambrosial nectar, which is being stolen by the thieves. No one can say no to them. He Himself protects us and blesses us with greatness. There are billions, countless billions of fire and desire at the seat of the mind. They are extinguished only with the water of understanding imparted by the Guru. Offering my mind, I have attained it, and I joyfully sing His glorious praises. Just as He is within the home of the self, so is He beyond. But how can I describe Him sitting in a cave? The fearless Lord is in the oceans, just as He is in the mountains. Tell me, who can kill someone who is already dead? What does He fear? Who can frighten the fearless one? He recognizes the word of the Shabad throughout the three worlds. One who speaks merely describes speech, but one who understands intuitively realizes. Seeing and reflecting upon it, my mind surrenders. Praise, beauty, and liberation are in the one name. In it, the Immaculate Lord is permeating and pervading. He dwells in the home of the self and in His own sublime place. The many silent sages lovingly praise Him. Their bodies and minds are purified as they enshrine the true Lord in their consciousness. O Nanak, meditate on the Lord each and every day. Gauri Gwareri, First Mahal. The mind does not die, so the job is not accomplished. The mind is under the power of the demons of evil, evil intellect, and evil duality. But when the mind surrenders through the Guru, it becomes one. The Lord is without attributes. The attributes of virtue are under His control. One who eliminates selfishness contemplates him. Pause. The deluded mind thinks of all sorts of corruption. When the mind is deluded, the load of wickedness falls on the head. But when the mind surrenders to the Lord, it realizes the one and only Lord. The deluded mind enters the house of Maya. Engrossed in sexual desire, it does not remain steady. O mortal, lovingly vibrate the Lord's name with your tongue. Elephants, horses, gold, children, and spouses, in the anxious affairs of all these people, lose the game of life and depart. In the game of chess, their pieces do not reach their destination. They gather wealth, but only evil comes from it. Pleasure and pain stand in the doorway. Intuitive peace comes by meditating on the Lord within the heart. When the Lord bestows his gracious glance, then he unites us in his union. Through the word of the Shabbat, merits are gathered in and demerits are burned away. The Gurmukh obtains the treasure of the Nam, the name of the Lord. Without the name, all live in pain. The consciousness of the foolish, self-willed Manmukh is the dwelling place of Maya. The Gurmukh obtains spiritual wisdom according to preordained destiny. The fickle mind continuously runs after fleeting things. The pure, true Lord is not pleased by filth. O Nanak, the Gurmukh sings the glorious praises of the Lord. Gauri, Gauriri, First Mahal. Acting in egotism, peace is not obtained. The intellect of the mind is false. Only the Lord is true. All who love duality are ruined. People act as they are preordained. I have seen the world to be such a gambler. All beg for peace, but they forget the Nam, the name of the Lord. Pause. If the unseen Lord could be seen, then he could be described. Without seeing him, all descriptions are useless. The Gurmukh sees him with intuitive ease. So serve the one Lord with loving awareness. People beg for peace, but they receive severe pain. They are all weaving a wreath of corruption. You are false. Without the One, there is no liberation. The Creator created the creation, and He watches over it. The fire of desire is quenched by the word of the Shabbat. Duality and doubt are automatically eliminated. Following the Guru's teachings, the Nam abides in the heart. Through the true word of his Bani, sing the glorious praises of the Lord. The true Lord abides within the body of that Gurmukh who enshrines love for him. Without the Nam, none obtain their own place. The beloved Lord King is dedicated to love. If he bestows his glance of grace, then we realize his name. Emotional attachment to Maya is total entanglement. The self-willed Manmukh is filthy, cursed, and dreadful. Serving the true Guru, these entanglements are ended. In the ambrosial nectar of the Nam, you shall abide in lasting peace. The Gurmukhs understand the one Lord and enshrine love for him. They dwell in the home of their own inner beings and merge in the true Lord. The cycle of birth and death is ended. This understanding is obtained from the perfect Guru. Speaking this speech, there is no end to it. I have consulted the Guru. and I have seen that there is no other door than His. Pain and pleasure reside in the pleasure of His will and His command. Nanak, the lowly, says embrace love for the Lord. Gaudi, First Mahal. The duality of Maya dwells in the consciousness of the people of the world. They are destroyed by sexual desire, anger, and egotism. Whom should I call the second when there is only the one? The one immaculate Lord is pervading amongst all. Pause. The dual-minded evil intellect speaks of a second. One who harbors duality comes and goes and dies. In the earth and in the sky, I do not see any second. Among all the women and the men, God's light is shining. In the lamps of the sun and the moon, I see His light. Dwelling among all is my ever-youthful beloved. In His mercy, He attuned my consciousness to the Lord. The true Guru has led me to understand the one Lord. The Gurumukh knows the one immaculate Lord. Subduing duality, one comes to realize the word of the Shabad. The command of the one Lord prevails throughout all the worlds. From the one, all have arisen. There are two routes, but remember, their Lord and Master is only one. Through the word of the Guru Shabad, recognize the hukam of the Lord's command. He is contained in all forms and all colors and minds. Says Nanak, praise the one Lord. Gaudi, First Mahal. Those who live a spiritual lifestyle, they alone are true. What can the false know about the secrets of liberation? Those who contemplate the way are yogis. They conquer the five thieves and enshrine the true Lord in the heart. Pause. Those who enshrine the true Lord deep within realize the value of the way of yoga. The sun and the moon are one and the same for them as our household and wilderness. The karma of their daily practice is to praise the Lord. They beg for the alms of the one and only Shabad. They remain awake and aware in spiritual wisdom and meditation and the true way of life. They remain absorbed in the fear of God. They never leave it. Who can estimate their value? They remain lovingly absorbed in the Lord. God unites them with Himself, dispelling their doubts. And by the Guru's grace, the supreme status is obtained. In the service of the Guru is reflection upon the Shabad. Subduing the ego, practice pure actions. Chanting, meditation, austere self-discipline and the reading of the Puranas, says Nanak, are contained in the surrender to the unlimited Lord. Gaudi, First Mahal. To practice forgiveness is the true fast, good conduct, and contentment. Disease does not afflict me, nor does the pain of death. I am liberated and absorbed into God who has no form or feature. What fear does the yogi have? The Lord is amongst the trees and the plants, within the household and outside as well. Pause. The yogis meditate on the fearless, immaculate Lord. Night and day they remain awake and aware, embracing love for the true Lord. Those yogis are pleasing to my mind. The trap of death is burnt by the fire of God. Old age, death, and pride are conquered. They swim across and save their ancestors as well. Those who serve the true Guru are the yogis. Those who remain immersed in the fear of God become fearless. They become just like the one they serve. The name makes a one pure and fearless. It makes the masterless become the master of all. I am a sacrifice to him. Such a person is not reincarnated again. They sing the glories of God. Inwardly and outwardly, they know the one Lord. Through the word of the Guru Shabad, they realize themselves. That one bears the banner and insignia of the true Shabad in the Lord's court. One who dies in the Shabad abides in their own home within. They do not come or go in reincarnation, and their hopes are subdued. Through the word of the Shabad of the Guru, their heart lotus blossoms forth. Whoever is seen is driven by hope and despair, by sexual desire, anger, corruption, hunger, and thirst. O Nanak, those detached recluses who meet the Lord are so very rare. Gaudi, first Mahal. Meeting such a slave, peace is obtained. Pain is forgotten when the true Lord is found. Beholding the blessed vision of his darshan, my understanding has become perfect. The cleansing baths at the 68 sacred shrines of pilgrimage are in the dust of his feet. Pause. My eyes are contented with the constant love of the one Lord. My tongue is purified by the most sublime essence of the Lord. True are my actions, and deep within my being, I serve him. My mind is satisfied by the inscrutable, mysterious Lord. Wherever I look, there I find the true Lord. Without understanding, the world argues in falsehood. When the Guru instructs, understanding is obtained. How rare is that Gurumukh who understands? Show your mercy and save me, O Savior Lord. Without understanding, people become beasts and demons. The Guru has said that there is no other at all. So tell me, who should I see and who should I worship? For the sake of the saints, God has established the three worlds. One who understands his own soul contemplates the essence of reality. One whose heart is filled with truth and true love, praise Nanak, I am their servant. Gaudi, first Mahal. Brahma acted in pride and did not understand. Only when he was faced with the downfall of the Vedas did he repent. Remembering God in meditation, the mind is conciliated. Such is the horrible pride of the world. The Guru eliminates the pride of those who meet him. Pause. Baal, the king, in Maya and egotism, held his ceremonial feasts, but he was puffed up with pride. Without the Guru's advice, he had to go to the underworld. Hari Chand gave in charity and earned public praise, but without the Guru, he did not find the limits of the mysterious Lord. The Lord himself misleads people, and he himself imparts understanding. The evil-minded Harnakash committed evil deeds. God, the Lord of all, is the destroyer of pride. He bestowed his mercy and saved Prahlad. Ravan was deluded, foolish, and unwise. Sri Lanka was plundered, and he lost his head. He indulged in ego and lacked the love of the true Guru. The Lord killed the thousand-armed Arjun and the demons Madhu, Kitab, and Mahakasa. he seized Harnakish and tore him apart with his nails. The demons were slain. They did not practice devotional worship. The demons Jada Sun and Kaal Jaman were destroyed. Rukat Bij and Kaal Nim were annihilated. Slaying the demons, the Lord saved his saints. He himself, as the true Guru, contemplates the Shabad. Because of the love of duality, God killed the demons. By their true devotion, the Gurumukhs have been saved. Sinking down, Duryodhan lost his honor. He did not know the Creator Lord. One who makes the Lord's humble servant suffer shall himself suffer and rot. Janamija did not know the word of the Guru's Shabad. Deluded by doubt, how could he find peace? Making a mistake for even an instant, you shall regret and repent later on. Kansa, the king, and his warriors Kays and Chandur had no equals. But they did not remember the Lord, and they lost their honor. Without the Lord of the universe, no one can be saved. Without the Guru, pride cannot be eradicated. Following the Guru's teachings, one obtains dynamic faith, composure, and the Lord's name. O Nanak, singing the glories of God, his name is received. Gauri, First Mahal. I may anoint my limbs with sandalwood oil. I may dress up and wear silk and satin clothes. But without the Lord's name, where would I find peace? So what should I wear? In what clothes should I display myself? Without the Lord of the universe, how can I find peace? Pause. I may wear earrings and a pearl necklace around my neck. My bed may be adorned with red blankets, flowers, and red powder. But without the Lord of the universe, where can I search for peace? I may have a beautiful woman with fascinating eyes. She may decorate herself with the 16 adornments and make herself appear gorgeous. But without meditating on the Lord of the universe, there is only continual suffering. In his hearth and home, in his palace, upon his soft and comfortable bed, day and night, the flower girls scatter flower petals. But without the Lord's name, the body is miserable. Horses, elephants, lances, marching bands, armies, standard bearers, royal attendants, and ostentatious displays. Without the Lord of the universe, these undertakings are all useless. He may be called a Siddha, a man of spiritual perfection, and he may summon riches and supernatural powers. He may place a crown upon his head and carry a royal umbrella. But without the Lord of the universe, where can truth be found? He may be called an emperor, a lord, and a king. He may give orders, do this now, do this then. But this is a false display. Without the word of the Guru Shabad, his works are not accomplished. Egotism and possessiveness are dispelled by the word of the Guru's Shabad. With the Guru's teachings in my heart, I have come to know the Lord. Praise Nanak, I seek your sanctuary. Gaudi, First Mahal. Those who serve the one Lord do not know any other. They abandon the bitter worldly conflicts. Through love and truth, they meet the truest of the true. Such are the humble devotees of the Lord. They sing the glorious praises of the Lord, and their pollution is washed away. Pause. The heart lotus of the entire universe is upside down. The fire of evil-mindedness is burning up the world. They alone are saved who contemplate the word of the Guru Shabad. The bumblebee, the moth, the elephant, the fish, and the deer all suffer for their actions and die. Trapped by desire, they cannot see reality. The lover of women is obsessed with sex. All the wicked are ruined by their anger. Honor and good sense are lost when one forgets the Nam, the name of the Lord. The self-willed Manmukh is lured by another's wife. The noose is around his neck and he is entangled in petty conflicts. The Gurumukh is emancipated, singing the glorious praises of the Lord. The lonely widow gives her body to a stranger. She allows her mind to be controlled by others for lust or money. But without her husband, she is never satisfied. You may read, recite, and study the scriptures, the Simritis, Vedas, and Puranas. But without being imbued with the essence of God, the mind wanders endlessly. As the rain bird thirsts longingly for the drop of rain, and as the fish delights in the water, Nanak is satisfied by the sublime essence of the Lord. Gauri, First Mahal. One who dies in stubbornness shall not be approved, even though he may wear religious robes and smear his body all over with ashes. Forgetting the Nam, the name of the Lord, he comes to regret and repent in the end. Believe in the dear Lord, and you shall find peace of mind. Forgetting the Nam, you shall have to endure the pain of death. Pause. The smell of musk, sandalwood, and camphor, and the intoxication of Maya takes one far away from the state of supreme dignity. Forgetting the Nam, one becomes the most false of all the false. Lances and swords, marching bands, thrones, and the salutes of others only increase his desire. He is engrossed in sexual desire. Without seeking the Lord, neither devotional worship nor the Nam are obtained. Union with God is not obtained by arguments and egotism. But by offering your mind, the comfort of the Nam is obtained. In the love of duality and ignorance, you shall suffer. Without money, you cannot buy anything in the store. Without a boat, you cannot cross over the ocean. Without serving the Guru, everything is lost. Waho! Waho, hail, hail to the one who shows us the way. Waho, waho, hail, hail to the one who teaches the word of the Shabad. Waho, waho, hail, hail to the one who unites me in the Lord's union. Waho, waho, hail, hail to the one who is the keeper of this soul. Through the word of the Guru's Shabad, contemplate this ambrosial nectar. The glorious greatness of the Nam is bestowed according to the pleasure of your will. Without the Naam, how can I live, O Mother? Night and day, I chant it. I remain in the protection of your sanctuary. O Nanak, attuned to the Naam, honor is attained. Gauri, First Mahal. Acting in egotism, the Lord is not known, even by wearing religious robes. How rare is that Gurumukh who surrenders their mind in devotional worship. By actions done in egotism, selfishness and conceit, the true Lord is not obtained. But when egotism departs, then the state of supreme dignity is obtained. Pause. The kings act in egotism and undertake all sorts of expeditions. But through their egotism, they are ruined. They die, only to be reborn over and over again. Egotism is overcome only by contemplating the word of the Guru's Shabad. One who restrains their fickle mind subdues the five passions. With the true Lord deep within the self, the celestial mansion is intuitively found. Understanding the Sovereign Lord, the state of supreme dignity is obtained. The Guru dispels the doubt of those whose actions are true. They focus their attention on the home of the fearless Lord. Those who act in egotism, selfishness, and conceit die. What do they gain? Those who meet the perfect Guru are rid of all conflicts. Whatever exists is in reality nothing. Obtaining spiritual wisdom from the Guru, I sing the glories of God. Egotism binds people in bondage and causes them to wander around lost. O Nanak, peace is obtained through devotional worship of the Lord. Gauri, First Mahal. First, Brahma entered the house of death. Brahma entered the lotus and searched the nether regions, but he did not find the end of it. He did not accept the Lord's order. He was deluded by doubt. Whoever is created shall be destroyed by death, but I am protected by the Lord. I contemplate the word of the Guru's Shabad. Pause. All the gods and goddesses are enticed by Maya. Death cannot be avoided without serving the Guru. The Lord is imperishable, invisible, and inscrutable. The sultans, emperors, and kings shall not remain. Forgetting the name, they shall endure the pain of death. My only support is the name of God. As he keeps me, I survive. The leaders and kings shall not remain. The bankers shall die after accumulating their wealth and money. Grant me, O Lord, the wealth of your ambrosial Naam. The people, rulers, leaders, and chiefs, none of them shall be able to remain in the world. Death is inevitable. It strikes the heads of the false. Only the one Lord, the truest of the true, is permanent. He who created and fashioned everything shall destroy it. One who becomes Gurumukh and meditates on the Lord is honored. The qazis, the sheikhs, and fakirs in religious robes call themselves great, but through their egotism, their bodies are suffering in pain. Death does not spare them without the support of the true Guru. The trap of death is hanging over their tongues and eyes. Death is over their ears when they hear talk of evil. Without the Shabbat, they are plundered day and night. Death cannot touch those whose hearts are filled with the true name of the Lord and who sing the glories of God. O Nanak, the Gurumukh is absorbed in the word of the Shabbat. Gauri, First Mahal. They speak the truth, not an iota of falsehood. The Gurumukhs walk in the way of the Lord's command. They remain unattached in the sanctuary of the true Lord. They dwell in their true home, and death does not touch them. The self-willed Manmukhs come and go in the pain of emotional attachment. Pause. So drink deeply of this nectar and speak the unspoken speech. Dwelling in the home of your own being within, you shall find the home of intuitive peace. One who is imbued with the Lord's sublime essence is said to experience this peace. Following the Guru's teachings, one becomes perfectly stable and never wavers. Following the Guru's teachings, one intuitively chants the name of the true Lord. Drinking in this ambrosial nectar and churning it, the essential reality is discerned. Beholding the true Guru, I have received his teachings. I have offered my mind and body after searching deep within my own being. I have come to realize the value of understanding my own soul. The Nam, the name of the Immaculate Lord, is the most excellent and sublime food. The pure swan souls see the true light of the Infinite Lord. Wherever I look, I see the one and only Lord. One who remains pure and unblemished and practices only true deeds obtains the supreme status, serving at the Guru's feet. The mind is reconciliated with the mind, and the ego's wandering ways come to an end. In this way, who has not been saved? The Lord's praises have saved his saints and devotees. I have found God. I am not searching for any other. The Guru has shown me the unseen mansion of the true Lord. His mansion is eternal and unchanging. It is not a mere reflection of Maya. Through truth and contentment, doubt is dispelled. The person within whose mind the true Lord dwells in his company, one becomes Gurumukh. O Nanak, the true name washes off the pollution.